Hello students, hope you are doing fine. I'm Poonam Dua from Eminent Education Academy of Literature and I'm here today to discuss some of the major terms used in English literature, and we will also study about the authors who coined those terms. This is part 2 of this kind of video and I have already uploaded part 1 around a week back. So I'll be giving you the description of that video also in the end. Please go through it. It is very important for any kind of literary exam aspirants. Please do not forget to share and subscribe my channel. Let us start with the first term. Who used the phrase first, negative capability? Negative capability was a phrase first used by romantic poet John Keats in 1817 to characterize the capacity of the writers, particularly Shakespeare, to pursue a vision of artistic beauty even when it leads them into intellectual confusion and uncertainty, as opposed to a preference of philosophical requirement. Regular watchers of my videos must be knowing that I conduct a quiz also in the end of most of the videos. In this video too, I'll provide a quiz so that the students are able to judge their knowledge themselves. Let us start with another term. Who associated the word problem play for William Shakespeare work? The term was coined by critic F.S. Bose in Shakespeare and his predecessor 1896, and this is term derived from a type of drama that was popular at the time of Bose's writing. It was most associated with Norwegian playwright Henrik Ibsen. The next term, metafiction. Metafiction was coined by whom? The term metafiction has remained enigmatic and vague since it was coined in 1970 by William H. Gass in an essay entitled Philosophy and the Form of Fiction. What is the origin of the phrase suspension of disbelief? This term was coined by S.T. Coleridge in 1817 with the publication of his Biographia Literaria, or Biographical Sketches of My Literary Life and Opinions. Suspension of belief is the willingness for a person to accept fantasy as it is represented to them in any form of media. The next, who coined the term poetic justice? It was coined by Thomas Rymer. The term was coined by the English literary critic Thomas Rymer in 17th century, when it was believed that a work of literature should contain moral principles and instruct the reader in correct moral behavior. The next, and I believe one of the famous term, deconstruction. Originated by the philosopher Jacques Derrida, deconstruction is an approach to understand the relationship between text and meaning. The purpose of this term is to show that the usage of language in a given text and language as a whole are very much The next two terms, affective fallacy and intentional fallacy. Affective fallacy is a term from literary criticism used to refer to the supposed error of judging or evaluating a text on the basis of its emotional effects on a reader. It was coined by Wimsett and Monroe Beardsley in 1949 as a principle of new criticism, which is often paired with the study of intentional fallacy. Intentional fallacy, which means to analyze a text as per the intention of author. The next one, who introduced the term magical realism? The term magical realism was introduced by Franz Roh, a German art critic, in 1925. When he coined the term, he meant it to create an art category that strayed from the strict guidelines of realism. The next one, who coined the term theater of absurd? This is a term coined by the critic Martin Eslin for the work of a number of playwrights, mostly written in 1950s and 60s, and the theme used to be absurdity. The term is derived from an essay by French philosopher Albert Camus in his Myth of Sisyphus, written in 1942. The next one, who coined the term university wits? University wits itself is a good topic of discussion for literary aspirants, and I have created a separate video on it. You people can ask for the link of that in the comment. Let us go with the term. The term university wits was not used in lifetime of the seven poets it was used for, but it was coined by George Saintsbury, a 19th century journalist and author. Next one, who is considered to be the inventor of the word sensuous? The answer is John Milton. In fact, the word sensuous is thought to have been invented by John Milton, and the word means in a deliberate attempt to avoid the sexual overtones of being sensual. Who coined the term essay? French author Michel de Montaigne coined the term when he assigned the title Essays to his first publication in 1580. Who coined the term gynocriticism or gynocritics? Gynocriticism or gynocritics is the term coined in the 1970s by Ellen Showalter to describe a new literary project intended to construct a female framework for the analysis of women's literature. I have created a quiz and the link is given in the description. Please appear for that. In that way, you will be able to understand your knowledge in a better sense. I'm sure the video proves to be helpful for you if you go through it thoroughly. Please subscribe to our channel to keep on getting such type of videos on regular basis and to gain more knowledge about English literature. You can also contact to join our face-to-face classes. Thanks a lot for watching and best of luck for your exams.